Welcome to the Cross-Border Interview Signature Series. From musicians to painters, from novelists to filmmakers, we're bringing you a diverse range of voices and perspectives, all united by their passion for the craft. And whether you're a longtime fan of theirs or a newcomer to their work, we're confident that you'll find something to inspire and captivate you in each and every one of these Signature Series interviews. All this week, we are heading to the most recent Calgary Expo, where we met with guests from across the entertainment industry who are all connected by their passion of their craft. Our guest today to kick off this week dedicated to Calgary Expo is the Vice President of Fan Expo HQ, Andrew Moyes. Andrew and I will discuss the 2024 Fan Expo and the feedback he has heard over the four-day convention in downtown Calgary, but also what's in store for 2025. This is Cross-Border Interview Signature Series featuring Andrew Moyes.
Andrew, thank you so much for doing this. Fan Expo, we're on the last day. How do you think it went?
Well, it's always a relief to be here on Sunday and know that there's been heaps of smiling faces and a really good experience for everyone. I feel really good. The energy online, the energy in the hall has been really great. I think the whole community has just once again enjoyed celebrating fandom all weekend.
This is a tough year for a lot of people from an economy standpoint, but it seems like people are here and they're willing to spend their money and they're willing to talk to their celebrities, they're willing to meet with the vendors. It's got to be something that the fandom will come together, even in challenging times, to help out and also support fandoms.
Well, I mean, this is entertainment, you know, and even in the toughest of times, we all need an escape. And so much of what this show is built on is about escapism. I mean, we've got Todd McFarlane here, one of the greatest comic creators that is creating those characters, Spider-Man, that we know and love, that we can escape into, that we can transform into. Look at all the costumes that are, on display around the center. Again, a way for people to transform, to escape, and also celebrate the characters that they know and love. So I think there'll always be a place for celebrating fandom. This is about passion. It's about togetherness with the community. So regardless of the pressures of the exterior world, there's always going to be a safe space here at Calgary Expo.
So let's talk about this year, if you don't mind. Last year was big. Was this year bigger? Do you have unofficial numbers yet? Or are you still seeing numbers trickling in because it is still the last day and we're still recording?
Yeah, we're still midway through Sunday, so no final count yet. But still some great support from the whole community. I mean, this show continues to be, of course, second largest signature event in the city. And you can just see the continued support. I mean, the Parade of Wonders is another example of how the whole city of Calgary comes behind this show, that massive display down Stephen Avenue. And look, we're so excited about all of our key partners, the hotels, the restaurants, this incredible transformation here at Stampede, you know, so everyone's benefiting from this signature event, but ultimately we're thrilled that the community is still out to support in strength.
So this is the last year that this venue is potentially going to be used, and next year we're going to be moving into the new venue. Are we expecting bigger and better? Because we always look at the future and what's next for any organization. So for Fan Expo Calgary, is it going to be bigger next year, or is there going to be some growing pains?
Well, look, we've all endured the construction. I think we can all safely say the whole of Calgary that's coming down to do events here, whether it be Stampede, whether regardless of the show you're coming to, over the past couple of years, we've endured, and we're so grateful for our fans who have just walked through that with us. This year has been very smooth in terms of transitioning and overall operations, and I think that's a really great stepping stone to what I think will be even easier next year. You can see we have a lot of signage on display, bigger, better 2025. I mean, that's our motto anyway. We're already working on 2025. How can we increase that fan experience? How can we make it better? But I have been lucky to have a bit of a tour of the new space. It is world class, and it's really going to help us take the show to the next level.
So yesterday I was talking and I was speaking to people from Saskatchewan, from British Columbia, all the way up north in northern Alberta, people from across Western Canada descend upon Calgary for these 4 days. Does it give you pride that Calgary is kind of standing out as a place where people want to come because the caliber of guests, the caliber of comic book creators, the caliber of even cosplayers are here and they want to come to Calgary?
Yeah, this is a signature Canadian event, you know, and we are bringing stars of a quality that people will travel for. And that's why we continue to have such a great economic impact. We're putting heads in beds. We're bringing people down to this fantastic center. I mean, you're going to be competing on the world stage anyway with this new facility. But you already are too in the entertainment space. I mean, Ghostbusters, The Last of Us, I mean, you're producing some amazing content. So Calgary's definitely on the map, and we like to think and feel that we are a part of that based on our event.
Is it easy to find guests who want to come to Calgary as well?
Well, it is unique. I mean, as I said, that Parade of Wonders, we do 16 of these shows across North America now in all key cities, Boston, Chicago, Orlando. This is the only one that has a parade. So that's really special. I mean, to see Todd McFarlane rolling down, again, Stephen Avenue, with all the fans cheering on, I mean, that is just personifies this community in that sense of celebration. So, and then the white hatting ceremony, I mean, it's very unique. There is a selling point in the sense that it's very different and has a different flavor to all our other events. So people are definitely curious, and it has a very good reputation.
This guy right here, our executive producer, was part of the white hatting ceremony because he was the former minister of tourism culture in Alberta. So he probably was at those white hat ceremonies. My final question for yourself, you must be a fan as well, looking at what's going on here. Is there things that are standing out for you saying, okay, we need to make sure we do this next year? Even if we don't do this, we have to make sure we do this.
Well, it's a surprise and delight, you know. I mean, this morning we had John Rhys-Davies and a couple of other Star Wars stars come out to a marching line of the 501st. And it just puts smiles on people's faces. You know, as we say, we're talking about that sense of escapism. We're talking about that sense of safe space. For me, it's creating those once-in-a-lifetime opportunities and seeing them come to life. And that's, you know, fans meeting celebrities. That's exhibitors in their basement making amazing products that people then come and compliment and purchase. It's people connecting in line and making new friendships. It just happens on so many levels, and that is my fandom, honestly. Creating a safe space for people to come and find a sense of belonging and celebration of fandom.
Andrew, thank you so much for doing this.
My pleasure.
We want to thank Calgary Expo for inviting us and having us for this four-day conference in downtown, beautiful downtown Calgary. This show could not have happened without their support. Now, if you've enjoyed this show and you want to keep up on all the latest signature series that we have coming to you, hit that subscribe button now. Until next time, stay informed, stay engaged, and most importantly, but as always, just keep talking.